The single cause fallacy is basically an oversimplification of a complex situation with complex causal relationships. It is also called causal reductionism. You must have heard about the heated debates in the United States whenever they talk about school shootings in the media. Pro-gun lobbyists will say, "This is all about video games," or "The school shooter snapped because of his parents, drugs, whatever." And anti-guns usually dismiss these arguments and claim the opposite, that the absence of regulation represents the reason for this situation. It is pretty common to try to find a single cause to an event and to say that one cause excludes the other. The fact that the shooter had psychiatric antecedents excludes the fact that law regulations on guns tend to favor school shootings. So how could it work in the field of data analysis? I've made an experiment to prove causal relationships between two variables of interest. Let's say, for instance, sleep quality and academic performances, grades. You made sure that you cannot be accused to make a confusion between correlation and causation by setting experimental groups and by controlling for the variables at hand. For instance, you ask a randomly constituted group of students to get sleep deprivation before an exam, and you compare the grades with those of a control group that slept well. You get the results, perform the tests required to show the difference is statistically significant. So far, so good. The argumentation becomes fallacious when you start claiming that the decrease we observed in academic performances for students who didn't sleep well is explained uniquely by students' sleeping habits. It is typically the kind of headlines you will find in newspapers, typically something in like of bad sleeping habits explained, poor academic performance. Of course, sleeping habits definitely influence grades, but reducing the problem to that single cause is pretty arguable, don't you think? It has a lot to do with how you phrase your sentences. For instance, if you say bad sleep is one of the main causes for bad grades, then there's enough nuance and you cannot tell it is a single cause fallacy. False dilemmas are pretty similar and represent arguments where you exclude alternative possibilities. They are not necessarily linked to the issue of causality. For instance, you are either with me or against me is a false dilemma that cannot be considered as a questionable cause. But they can definitely be applied to causal explanations. If you are trying to explain, let's say, a 30% decline in bee populations and you end up saying it's either pesticides or climate change that caused bee populations to decline, then your argument is a false dilemma, at least if your two explanations are mutually exclusive. The difference with the single cause here is just lies in the fact that you have two explanations instead of one. But apart from that, it's pretty much the same. Always be nuanced and open to alternative explanations, and you should be able to avoid these obstacles.